of the celebration of nuptial vows, wedding Alicia and Sebastian here at St. Mary Church. Let us pray. Be attentive to our prayers, O Lord, and in your kindness of all that you have established for the increase of the human race, so that the union you have created may be kept safe by your assistance. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
I invite you to please be seated.
Reading from the book of Proverbs. When one finds a worthy wife, a volume is far beyond pearls. A husband entrusts his heart to her as a Napoleon price. She brings in good and not evil all the days of her life. She obtained wool and flour, and made cloth and silk for hand. She put her hands to the distaff, and her fingers to the spindle. She reached out her hands to the poor and extended her arms to the needy. Charm is deceptive and beauty is fleeting. The woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Give her a reward of her labor and let her work praise the name at the city gate. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, strive eagerly for the greatest spiritual gifts. But I shall show you a still more excellent way. If I speak in human and angelic tongues, but do not have love, I am a resounding gong or a clashing cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and comprehend all mysteries and all knowledge, if I have all faith so as to move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away everything I own, and if I hand my body over so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. It is not jealous, is not pompous, it is not inflated, it is not rude, it does not seek its own interests, it is not quick-tempered, it does not brood over injury, it does not rejoice over wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. Love never fails. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. Weddings make grooms very nervous. Brides love this. Probably since the second or third grade you've been playing bride, and here's your chance. Sebastian, well, it just occurred that he's getting married. So we're going to be very kind to him. And we'll move things along just a little bit, but with great dignity. We love you both. We pray for you both. And you have our sincere congratulations. I would invite the witnesses to come forward at this time. Dearly beloved, you have come together into the house of the church, so that in the presence of the church's minister and the community, your intention to enter into marriage may be strengthened by the Lord with a sacred seal. Christ abundantly blesses the love that binds you. Through a special sacrament, he enriches and strengthens those he has already consecrated by holy baptism, that they may be faithful to each other forever. Assume all the responsibilities of married life. And so, in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intentions. Leisha and Sebastian, have you come here to end in marriage without coercion, freely, and wholeheartedly?
I have.
Are you prepared, as you follow the path of marriage, to love and honor each other as long as you both shall live?
I am.
Are you prepared to accept children lovingly from God and bring them up before the law of Christ and his church?
I am.
Since it is your intention to enter the covenant of holy matrimony, I ask you to turn from the Lord and declare your consent before God and his church.
I, Sebastian,
take you,
Delicia,
to be my wife.
I promise to be faithful to you.
I promise to be faithful to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love you.
To love you.
And to honor you.
And to honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
I, Delicia.
Take you, Sebastian. To be my husband.
To be my husband.
I promise to be faithful to you.
I promise to be faithful to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love you.
To love you.
And to honor you.
And to honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
May the Lord in his kindness strengthen the consent you've declared before the church and graciously bring to fulfillment his blessing within you. What God joins together, let no one put asunder. The rings.
Delicia,
receive this ring as a sign of my love,
as a sign of my love
and fidelity,
and fidelity
in the name of the Father,
in the name of the Father,
and of the Son,
and of the Son,
and of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Take that for place on your husband's ring and repeat it for me. Sebastian.
Sebastian.
Receive this ring.
Receive this ring.
As a sign of my love.
As a sign of my love.
And fidelity.
And fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And
of the Holy Spirit. And of the Holy Spirit.
Please stand for the prayers of the faithful as Lucia leads us in our attention. Dear brothers and sisters, let us accompany this new family in our prayers, that the mutual love of this couple may grow daily, that God, in his kindness, will sustain all.
That these faithful Christians, Sebastian and Felicia, newly joined in holy matrimony, may always enjoy health and well-being. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That he will bless their covenant as he chose to sanctify marriage in Cana in Galilee. Let us pray to the Lord. That they be granted perfect and fruitful love, peace, and strength, and that they bear faithful witness to the name of Christian. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
that the Christian people may grow in virtue day by day, and that who are burdened by any need may receive the help of grace from above. Lord, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for all members of our families who have passed from this world and for all that have departed, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
that the grace of the sacrament will be renewed by the Holy Spirit in all married persons here present, let us pray to the Lord.
Graciously pour out upon this husband and wife, O Lord, the spirit of your love, to make them of one heart and one soul, so that nothing whatever may divide those who have joined, and no harm those who have filled with your blessing, through Christ our Lord. Please be seated as the gifts are presented.
Thank you.
sealing the sacred bond of marriage. And just as your goodness is its origin, may your providence guide its course through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. You have forged the cup of marriage as a sweet yoke of harmony and an unbreakable bond of peace. Let the chaste and fruitful love of holy matrimony may serve to increase the children you adopt as your own. By your providence and grace, O Lord, you accomplish the wonder of this twofold design. That while the birth of children brings beauty to the world, that rebirth and baptism gives increase to the church through Christ our Lord. For him, the angels, and all the saints who sing the hymn of your praise as without end, be acclaimed.
Together with Francis, our Pope, and Leonard, our Bishop, and the Holy Virgin. Remember also our
Thank you.
May God